In the early days of television, there weren't many programs to choose from. But if you did want to change channel, you had to walk all the way across the living room to do it.
There are very few innovators who are really the true inventors within CEDIA. And Mr. Park is one of those. He has truly changed the course of control. When you think of features that millions of people use today in any control system, Favorites is an example of something that really came from Mr. Park.
He is the true American success story. Mr. Park came here with $200. $100 of that was stitched into his pants, and he landed here not speaking a word of English.
He had the love of his family behind him, and he had his bright mind, his dogged spirit, and aspirations to succeed.
With the introduction of internet, our way of life has changed significantly. I believe people will look back and call this information revolution. CEDIA is in a unique position to harness this technology and make people's daily lives so much easier.
We decided to try and determine how many remotes we've manufactured and shipped over the past 10 years. And we were all shocked when the figure came out to be 100 million.
He instinctively looks to make people's lives better. That translates from his philanthropic endeavors all the way through to everything that he does in his company URC.
I start with a different type of business, supplying the component to the TV and monitor manufacturer, and one of the parts happened to be the remote control. When I saw it, I thought that there's great potential if I put in my time and effort. As our industry provides high-quality audio and video in the 1990s, our typical installers focused on new and better equipment. The last thing they have in their mind was controlling the whole system. I thought to myself, someday control will be a forethought, not an afterthought. I believe that someday is here today.
The original remote control was so big we couldn't lose it. Now we have a whole array of them, television, for DVDs, for air conditioning. They've changed the way we live our lives.
URC's roots have always been in remote controls. Over the years with Mr. Park's vision, we've been able to evolve our business from being entertainment-centric to controlling the entire smart home.
He was able to go from Wi-Fi to whole house control over IP-based systems. He has really been on the forefront of control technology throughout his body of work.
Well, I think your question is getting harder and harder.
Mr. Park is one of the most genuine, humble people I've met in this industry and perhaps in life.
I am so delighted that CEDIA decided to recognize one of the quiet giants in our industry.
He presents his position in a very quiet and inviting way, always inviting discussion, always asking other people their views.
In a world sort of driven by ego and publicity these days, Mr. Park prefers to be leading the charge sort of quietly but with strength from behind the scenes.
That design and ergonomics of remotes have always been a hallmark of URC. Mr. Park leads that charge by having a very collaborative style with employees. It's not uncommon for him to come up with a new design, give it to an employee to take home for his family to all weigh in on, and he genuinely cares about that feedback.
I went to one of the first trainings for their home automation system. During part of that, Mr. Park shuffled into the room, the shy guy that he is, and his eyes just lit up, and you could tell he was so grateful for every single dealer that was in that room. He's grateful for his customers, for his employees, for his cohorts, for this opportunity that America has given him.
It's been a real pleasure to work with Mr. Park over the years, not only because through his vision, URC has been a successful and growth-oriented company, but also because he deeply cares about his employees and consistently and constantly empowers us to be the best that we can be.
I look up to him as a role model. In his humility, he allows me to think of him as a friend and as a partner in the work of doing good in the world.
As a person of faith, I believe that what I have is a gift entrusted in me, and I try to be a good steward of that gift. There's no need for people to go through so much suffering. If there's a way we can reduce that suffering, I'd like to do something about it.